Welcome to How to Take a Film Photo with Victoria Becker. Thank you for tagging along. So, to begin, there is an automatic camera or a manual camera where you do the settings yourself. For the purposes of this tutorial, we will be working with a Canon AE-1, a very common film camera for the go-to film user. And we'll just start off by going over the settings. So there's on and off, obviously at the top there. Then next off, we'll go to the lens, where there's two essential parts to it, the aperture and the focus, and we'll go over those in a little bit. But for the focus, it's quite self-explanatory, back and forth to get the focus. And the last but not least, we'll talk about shutter speed as well, which is your dial to the right there. So there are different types of film that you can buy. This is a black and white type of film. The one that I'll be showing you to put into my camera is just a regular Fuji 400 film. It has 36 exposures on it, which means 36 pictures, but others offer you 24. It just depends. So, how to load your film. You'll start by pressing the button at the bottom of your camera and then flipping it upwards. And then there'll be that round circular thing to the left. You'll pull that up. Some cameras have a little button you have to push. Most don't, though. They should just pop open for you like that. Then you will make sure that you're loading your filming correctly. So there's a positive and a negative to your film. So you want to make sure that the negative is the space that you have at the top. It's kind of like a battery. You'll figure out if it's in there correctly or not. Then you're going to measure it out. And the good thing with this is that if you take too much, you can push it back in. And if there's not enough, just pull more. So there should be little teeth that you feel there with your thumb. Then you're going to feed it in to those little slots that you feel and turn it as though you're going to take a picture after. So once you think you have it let in, make sure you turn it once to see that it's been pulled through, and ta-da, you've put your film in. Next up, I just want to really highlight that in between photos, you have to turn the knob on the side, you see that? And then you press the button. You can actually see on the left that the film is being rolled in. Next up, we're going to talk about shutter speed. So that is essentially how quickly your camera lens is closing. So if we're at 1,000, it's going to be closing extremely fast. So that's going to be the ch-ch-t, like a really ch-ch-t, really, really quick closing of your shutter. So that's going to be for like sporting events or things where people aren't sitting still. So if we are doing something where you want to have that blurred effect, or possibly it's very dark out and you want to capture as much light as possible, then you're going to go low on your camera settings. I wouldn't suggest going very low, but still low. And that's going to be the type sound that comes out of your camera when you're taking the photo. Next up, we will take a look at our aperture. So that is the diaphragm or the eyeball of your camera. So that's how much light is going to be let in. So if it's dark outside, like in this photo, you're going to want to let a lot of light in. So you're going to have your diaphragm very open, which is a lower setting. Whereas if you have a very bright photo, like the one near the water, you're going to want to have a lesser amount of light come in because you don't want to oversaturate the photo and have too much light. Lastly, we are going to look up how to take our film out of the camera. So this is what we're going to do when we've taken all our pictures. You'll figure this out when you go to take a picture and it won't let you press the button down anymore. So you press the button on the bottom and then you're going to go to the top and there should be a knob there. So this knob should pull up quite easily for you and it's going to go clockwise. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. You're going to take it and spin it as much as you can. Keep spinning and you'll feel it once it's done. You'll feel that there'll be no more tension, as well as the number in your photos will show that there's none. So you'll pull up and ta-da, you'll have a fully finished roll of film in there. And this is what it should look like. So it should just be all your film in there. You'll know you shot it properly if there's none left over. So thank you. This has been How to Take a Film Photo. It was a bit brief, a bit quick, but there's quite a bit to go over. If you have any questions, I would love to receive an email. Thank you so much.